Students, now we are taking the class of class 9, commercial studies, and the topic is nature and the scope of business. There are about 2 days classes already we have did, and out of that we have discussed about the business, what is the business, what are the characteristics or features of business. There are about 14 to 15 points were there, all we have discussed shortly, that you will read carefully from your book. Today we will discuss about the business activities. In this class, we will discuss in the chapter, Nature and Scope of Business is the name of the chapter. Under this, we will discuss about the business activities. So, we will discuss about the business activities. In the business activities, there are so many parts that have been separated in so many parts. So, in the business activities, have been divided in 2 parts firstly. What are the 2 parts? One is industrial activities. Industrial activities, and another is commercial activities. Here, industrial activities and commercial activities. In the industrial activity, what is industrial activity? All industrial activities are related to the production of goods. Different type of goods we have produced in our life, which have been ultimately sold to the different type of customers in their life. So those are mainly related with the production of goods. Yeah. And industrial activities also subdivided in 4 parts. What are the 4 parts that I am writing? So I think you are clear about the industrial activities. Industrial activities are those activities by which the different type of industrial products have been produced by man, machine, money. Using those different type of things, we are producing different type of goods, which ultimately reach to the hand of the customers who are using it in their daily life. So, what are the 4 different types of industrial activities that I have written? Industrial activities, number 1 is manufacturing activities. Number 2, better to write manufacturing industry. Better manufacturing industry. Yeah. Next, genetic industry. Next, extractive industry. Next, construction industry. clear? So, in the industrial activities, those different type of industries are there. Manufacturing industry, genetic industry, extractive industry and construction industry. What is manufacturing industry? Manufacturing industry are those industries who are manufacturing different type of goods, items, products for using by the different type of customers in our society. But to produce such type of goods through the industrial sector or manufacturing industry, those man, machine, money or capital have been introduced. So many different type of raw materials are there into the market. Those raw materials have been consumed at first, then those raw materials through the different type of machines have been transformed into the partly finished goods or semi-finished goods or work in progress. Slowly, slowly, by using those man, machine, money, those have been ultimately reached to the finished products or finished goods, which have been ultimately sold to the customers. What are the manufacturing industries example? Like cement industry, like sugar industry, like textile industry. Those are the example of manufacturing industry. Clear? What is manufacturing industry? Now, number two, genetic industry. Genetic industry are those industries that which we are by the process of breeding of plants, animals, we are getting such type of industry. Genetic, like different type of small plants have been transformed in different type of other plants. Likewise, or the different type of animals, like poultry farming. Poultry farming, that is under the process of genetic industry. There are so many sheep farming are there in the different type of other countries like New Zealand, Australia, few South American countries. So, those genetic industry, main example is the poultry farm. Fisheries, also a part of the genetic industry. There, different part of the country, you can see that the fishing or horticultural farm are there. In those farms, such type of industrial products are coming out and those have been sold to the different customers. So, fishing, horticultural, poultry farming, those are under the head of the genetic industry. Next is extractive industry. What is extractive industry? Extractive industry means by the extracting from beneath the soil or from the below the soil or from air or from water, such type of extracted workout we are getting. So, best example of the extractive industry is the mines, like gold mines, coal mine, diamond mines, which are extracting from beneath the surface and by the processing of different machines or by using huge number of man or other materials, those have been transformed into the different goods like gold, make ornaments. You are getting different type of diamonds into the market. Those also extracted from beneath the soil. Yeah. So from the water also we are getting so many different type of product. So what we are extracting, those are under the head of the extractive industry. Mainly minings are there under the head of the extractive industry. So clear? I think what is extractive? That is extracting from the beneath the soil, and mines is the best example. We are getting gold, diamond, silver or other so many different type of materials which we are using in our daily life. Next is construction industry. Construction industry mainly depending on the manufacturing industry and extractive industry. Why? Because to construct different dam, building, bridge, road, so many things, railway lines, those are under the head of the construction industry. Yes, so many man, machine and the materials as well as capital is invested into this. So, what we are manufacturing, ultimately it goes to the next active part goes to under the head of the construction industry, and which we are extracting here from the soil, we are making different type of bricks. So that is also used into the construction industry. Manufacturing industry producing cement, that is also using in the construction industry. So construction industry has a vital role in developing a society or making a better infrastructure, but that are depending on the manufacturing industry and extractive industry. Yes. So in the construction industry, what we are told that the building, bridge, dam, canals, those railway lines, those have been produced under the head of the construction industry. I think you are clear all the four different regulation as well as the example I have given to you. So it is the under the head of industrial activities. Now we will come into the commercial activities. But one thing, sufficient space are not there, so I am erasing this part. Here, and then I am writing all the commercial activities, different or subdivisions. Commercial activities, we have written in the industrial activities, that is a production of goods. This is distribution of goods. Commercial activities is the distribution of goods. Distribution of goods and rendering services. Why? Because there you know the definition of business. After that, there is a commerce. Commerce. What is commerce? Commerce is the distribution of goods and services properly from the producer or manufacturer to the wholesaler, to the retailer, to the ultimate consumer, by which the distribution of different type of goods which have been manufactured in different type of extractive industrial sector, genetic industrial sector or extractive industrial sector, those must be distributed ultimately to the hand of the customers from the producer manufacturer. That is the duty of the commerce. That is the actual characteristics of the commerce. So, commercial activities mainly involve with the distribution of goods and services properly, by which any type of hindrances or the obstacles may not come between the producer and the customer or the consumer. That must be carefully done by the commerce. So, commercial activities is the main thing to distribute different type of goods or services reaches everywhere of the society in our country. So now we are subdividing the commercial activities and we will write the definition of them also. At first, commercial activities have been divided in two parts. One is trade, another is aids to trade. Clear? Trade and aids to trade. What is trade? Trade means distribution of goods and services with a profit motive. So, in commerce or commercial activity, say you have read already, that this is a distribution properly without any obstacles or hindrances from the producer or manufacturer to the ultimate hand of the consumers. But in the trade, trade is the trading or exchanging goods and services with a profit motive. Exchanging goods and services with a profit motive. Without profit, trade may not run. So sometimes loss may arise, but nobody are starting their business that they will do the trade properly without profit. Where business profit must be there. Sometimes loss may arise. So here about the trade, what is the aids to trade? Trade cannot be done smoothly or softly without the help of the different type of organization or institution. Here, so those are called aids to trade. Aids means help. Aids means help. Help to trade. Which type of organization or institutions of the society are helping the trade? Called they are under the head of the aids to trade. That we will come next time elaborately. First, trade. Trade has been subdivided into two parts. One is home trade, another is foreign trade. Clear? First is home trade. Next is home trade and foreign trade. What is home trade? Home trade, which is within the boundary of the country. Home trade is which trade have been done within the boundary of the country, that is the selling or transacting different type of goods and services with a profit motive, that is called home trade. Here, within the boundary of the country, when the goods and services transacting or exchanging with a profit motive, that is called home trade. Foreign trade means the trade which is outside the boundary of the country. They are exchanging or transacting different type of goods and services with the different type of countries of the world with our country called foreign trade. Here, foreign trade is the exchange or transacting different type of goods and services with a profit motive with the other countries of the world called foreign trade. Here, then what is home trade and what is foreign trade? Home trade also subdivided into two parts that I am writing. First one is wholesale trade. Next is retail trade. Here, what is wholesale trade? Wholesale trade means which trade have been done between the producer and the wholesaler. That means a producer or manufacturer of different type of goods have been sold to the wholesaler or distributor who have the huge amount of capital to invest into the business, and they are purchasing lot of goods, but very small quantity, then this is called wholesale trade. Clear? Then what the wholesaler are doing? They are the link between the manufacturer or producer and the retailer. Clear? They are the link between. But wholesaler are helping as well as the producer and the retailer also, because they are investing lot of money into the business. Different type of goods are not there. Very small category, very few categories are there, but a lot of goods are there in the hand of the wholesaler. What is retail trade? Retail trade actually made by the retailers who are in our locality, you can see maximum number of shops or the businessmen in our locality are the retailers. They are purchasing maximum or large variety of goods, but a very small quantity from the wholesaler or distributor they are purchasing. Ultimately, they are selling to the customers or consumers. So they are the link between the wholesaler as well as the retail consumer or customer. They have not large amount of money, but small amount have been invested by them. So that is retail trade. Here, everyone, then home trade I have defined. What is the separation of the home trade? There is wholesale and retail trade. You have got the idea about it. Now we are discussing about the foreign trade. Foreign trade is that, foreign trade I have already discussed, still I am repeating. Foreign trade is that trade which is outside the boundary of the country and transacting and exchange of goods and services with a profit margin made by our country with the different type of countries of the world. Now, foreign trade have different subdivision. What are they? See, look at it. Import trade. Next, export trade. Next, re-export trade. Yeah. So foreign trade has three subdivision. I think you can see it clearly. Acha. Foreign trade, import trade, export trade, and re-export trade. Three subdivision are there. What is import trade? When we are purchasing goods from the foreign countries to consume by the different people of our country, different consumers are there in the society. Who are consuming this, then those are called import trade. That means we are purchasing or buying goods from the other countries of the world. Then it is import. And what is export? Export means we are selling our country's goods into the other countries of the world. That is called export trade. Yeah. So we are the producer in that case and selling it to the different countries of the world. That is called export trade. Yeah. Next, re-export trade. Re-export trade, another name is entry port trade. Clear? What is re-export trade or entry port trade? That trade which have been made by our country, but not the goods have been consumed by us. Like, suppose we are purchasing goods from the different countries, but not consuming by our country's people. And that will be transported to different other countries by refining it in different ways. So that is called re-export trade or import trade. Repeating, that means when our country are purchasing or buying goods from the different countries and after refining or after making in different transformation to make it finished goods, then sell it to the other countries, then it is called re-export trade or import trade. I think clear? Like crude oil, which have been consumed by us in our country, but sometimes those crude oil have been purchased by the Middle East countries like Kuwait, Bahrain, Saudi Arabia, Iraq, Iran, and ultimately all the material crude oil have not been consumed by us. But few are refined and sell it to the other countries like Bangladesh or so many other countries of the world according to their need and requirement. Those are called re-export trade or import trade. Here, not consuming by us, but purchasing, and after refining, after finishing or after making it into finished product, sell it to the other countries. I think clear everything. Now we are coming to the aids to trade, erasing this part because we have no sufficient space to write aids to trade subdivisions. Now I am writing subdivision of x to k. Next day we will discuss aids to trade. How much I have discussed today, read it carefully from your book and learn it also, because everything has been elaborately I have discussed. And next day we will start from aids to trade onwards. Remember it. Thank you, boys and girls.